Now, if you're not familiar with this function, you should probably learn about it. I'm going to link to series covering everything you need to know about it. But on this one, I'm going to create a new worksheet here, and let's just create a simple statement. So I'm going to do equals and start my function. Open parentheses, and then we need the data. So I'm going to go to this worksheet text, and basically I need to select this data. I'm just going to go ahead and select about this much and drop the end reference to go all the way down, and then comma, and then we need our select statement. So if you wanted all columns, then you would do select star, and then you can do the rest of the statement, filtering, whatever else you have to do. But for right now, that's where I'm going to concentrate. And then here we're going to do the number of header rows, so just one, and that should give us pretty much a copy of that data. Now, if I didn't want all the columns and I wanted some of them, let's say I want gender, then first name, and then last name. So that would be A, C, and E. Then I would go here and do select A, comma, C, comma, E to just get those columns. And as you can see, that's what I get. Now, the challenge here is if we have a lot of columns, and let's say we want everything starting from A up to, let's say, J, and then we want to skip these three columns and then get the rest of these going right, there is no way to do a range of columns built in this function to be able to do that. And if you have 70 or 80 columns, all of a sudden you have this challenge, you're gonna have to deal with this crazy function that has all those columns separated by a comma. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna get around that problem. And there are a few different ways to go about this. One of the ways to go about this is to not use that part of the data at all and basically just use only the columns you need by using an array. So one thing I'm going to go through first here, I'm going to go through changing the syntax. So by default, the syntax is to list the columns here, but we can also just go here and convert this range to an array using this curly brackets. And at that point, if I hit enter, I'm going to get an error because with an array, this syntax is no longer valid. So now I have to go with column numbers by doing COL1, COL3, and this is, by the way, case sensitive, so uppercase C and the rest lowercase, something like that. So I'm gonna do this, and I didn't get one of them right. This was probably 5, not 7. There we go. So we got this. See, now we can refer to this with their column indexes by saying first, third, fifth column from this list of columns. So 1, 3, 5. So now if I wanted pretty much to get all the columns except, let's say, these three columns in the middle, I'm going to have a couple of options. The first option is going to be if you don't need to use this data in these columns and you're not filtering by it or doing some other action using these columns at all, then just don't use those in your statement. So what I could do, I could go back in here, and here when I'm selecting the data, I'm going to get back to this and reselect the data, and I'm going to go inside of this brackets, go to my data and select basically everything until that column right here. I'm going to drop the end reference like this. So this is the first part of my data. Then I'm going to do a comma for my array columns. And then for the second part, I'm just going to skip those columns I don't need and go to the rest of this data like this. And again, drop the end reference to go all the way down. So basically now I have this two different parts of this data, see, selected in this array like that. At this point, if I wanted all those columns that I selected, I could just do select star to get all those columns. Because I haven't selected these middle ones, they're just not going to show up. So if I hit enter, see, I'm going to get these, and then we're going to see how after age, it jumps to our tracking codes, which is basically, see, after age, we have our tracking code. So that's one way to do that range of columns without having to list every single column in your statement. And then you could just do multiple different ranges here by simply just comma separating. If you have like different areas from your data you need, you can just comma separate all of those. Now again, depending on your settings, those commas might be actually these signs. Watch my syntax video for more details about that. For now, that will be it. So you just have to remember that now you have a new array, and in this array, if you have to do something with those columns and filter with those columns, you just have to go with that column number, and you have to remember that column number is going to be within the range you selected. So what that actually means is that if you wanted to now have this filtered, let's say by occupation, the column number for occupation, if you just count from here, is going to be see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And what you need to do, you need to skip counting these because they're not a part of our data. So you would then go 11, 12. And that would be column number 12 if you needed to filter that by occupation. Now, the plan B here is to do something different, assuming you may need some of those columns that we're not displaying, but you still want to do this range. Then what we can do, we can build that statement. So I'm going to change this, first of all, to our original data. Let's just undo this until I get there. So that should be good enough. See, this was the whole data from A through T, which is basically this whole thing all the way up to this end. So at this point, if I wanted to get, let's say, from here up to this age column, I need something that's gonna say COL 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, all comma separated next to each other. Now, I don't want to write all of that in my statement. So instead, what I'm going to do, I'm going to build that. So the way we can build that is by using, for example, the sequence function. So in this function, I can do 1 for number of rows, comma, and then let's say for number of columns, I do something like 4. So right now, if I just close parentheses and hit enter, you'll see that what I get is 1, 2, 3, 4. And then if I change this to 5, or 3, you can probably guess what's going to happen. So basically, I'm just going to get 3 in this case. Now, one other thing here is that after this column, if I do a comma, there's also an option to do the starting number. So for example, by default, it starts with a 1. So if I just type 1, it's still going to go 1, 2, 3. However, if I go and change this 1 to, let's say, 7, then it's going to start from 7 and it's going to go 3 columns, so 7, 8, 9. So again, 7 is the starting point and 3 is the column number. So we got 3 columns starting from 7, so I got 7, 8, 9. Now, in the case that I was referring to, I needed to get from 1 to 10. So what I could do, 1, 10. And because starting point by default is 1, I don't have to do like a starting number here. So I'm going to get basically first 10 columns. So if I do this, see, it's going to give me a range of basically 10 like that. Now, I don't need this, however. I need something that's going to look like col 1, comma, col 2, and comma, and so on until I have all of those, right? And you don't really need those spaces after those commas, but you could also have those spaces if you wanted to. Now, to do that, I'm going to go back to this, and I'm going to concatenate that COL like this in the beginning of this, and with an ampersand, we'll concatenate that text in the beginning with the sequence. And because it's going to be an array of values, I'm going to have to use Control-Shift-Enter or Command-Shift-Enter to get array formula around this and hit Enter. And now what should happen, see, it's going to be instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it's COL 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, we need just comma-separated list. We don't need these in separate columns like this. So for that, I can take all of this. I'm going to just add some spaces to make this clear and use this inside of a function join. And in this function, we can provide a delimiter. So basically what we want to have as a separator when we join them. So I'm going to do comma and a space. And then this comma will be our function comma for join. And then we'll provide this whole sequence thing as the array of values to join. So right now, if I enter, you're going to see that I got this text that gives me all those columns, comma separated. So if you remember, if I go back to the statement, it needs to say basically select space and basically all of these columns. That needs to be the statement over here. So what I'm missing is that select part in the beginning. So to add that, I'm going to go back to this. And right before this join, I'm going to in quotations do select. And we need a space after the word select. And then we're going to use ampersand again to concatenate that joined statement to that select. So now if I hit enter, see, I got select and all those columns. So at this point, I could just take all of that, copy it without the equal sign, and I'm going to delete that actually from here, go back to this statement and replace this with that function. I'm going to hit enter. And that should give me everything from column 1 up to 10, as you can see. So I'm going to change that from 1 to 3 for now, or 4. That should give us the first 4 columns if I do that. See? I'm going to change it back to 3. I'll come back and add 10 to this. But what I want to show you is now, let's say you also need to get these columns in the end. So that would be, if this was 10, I guess this would be 11, 12, 13, then 14, 15, 16. So we need now 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, basically until we get to this. So for that, we need something that starts from 14. So we're going to do sequence, and number of rows is going to be 1, and we're going to have some number of columns. For now, I'm going to just type something like 4, and then we're going to start from 14. So right now, it's going to start 14, 15, 16, 17. So assuming I got this number right, and this was actually 14, then if I go from here, then we need 7 columns to get to the end. So therefore, we would have to do 1 to 7, 7 columns, starting from 14. So that should get us this. And then we're going to continue doing the same thing I was doing before. I'm going to do that col concatenation to have the column. We're going to do our Ctrl-Shift-Enter or Command-Shift-Enter and hit Enter. That should give us these columns. And at that point, we also need to have our join function to put this all together. So I'm going to do join and join it with a comma and a space like this, comma, and then close this whole thing in the end. So that should give us, see, from column 14 up to 20. So now I'm going to take that formula, copy it, get rid of this, go back to that right here, and we need to basically add that to this existing one that we already had that goes up to here. Now, we don't really need two array formula functions here, but since I copied it, I'm just going to keep it. So we're going to go in here and do an ampersand to, again, join that. And I'm going to paste that second array formula function in here. So if I had enter right now, well, I got a value error. Let's see what we got. So see, it says we have col3 and then col4. It doesn't understand what this means. And the reason for that, to show you what happened there, I'm just going to copy this part of this formula and just put it in a separate cell so you can see what's happening there and why this isn't working right now. So I'm just going to put this in here. So you'll see what happened is that as I was joining those things, we got the first part here, right? So that goes column 1, 2, 3. And then we should have a comma before we go column 14, 15, 16, 17. But we don't have that comma right now, so we get an error because this is an invalid column. So to fix that, when we join these things together, we need to add that comma in here. So after this ampersand here, I'm going to do a comma and do another ampersand to join the rest of the stuff. So now, see, we got an extra comma here. Just to make this nice, I'm going to add a space in there too, within those quotes, just like that. So now we got this. And again, to make this a little more clean, I'm going to use one array formula instead of two. So what I would have to do, I would have to find the closing of this array formula. So if I just click on this opening, see, this is the closing right there, that parentheses. So I'm going to remove that parentheses right there. And then I'm going to also remove this opening array formula for the second one. So that should now take care of this and just have one array formula around this whole thing, and it's still gonna work. So at this point, I can just copy this, go back to this one and replace this whole thing with my formula that gives me that range. And if I hit enter, see, I get, starting from our tracking codes, getting back to this end. And if I wanted to also get the first 10 columns here instead of the first three, I can just go and update this 3 to 10. And that should give me that. And that should cover that. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.